You're listening to Mediums, Psychics, and Channelers, Volume 3, a compilation of conversations from Emmy Award-winning journalist Jenniffer Weigel from her podcast, I'm Spiritual Dammit. For more books written or hosted by Jenniffer, visit her website, jenweigel.com.
Welcome to I'm Spiritual Dammit. I'm your host, Jenniffer Weigel, and joining me in studio, the one and only Chris Fleming. How are you, Chris?
I'm wonderful, Jen. Thanks for having me on. I appreciate it.
Well, thanks for making time in your busy schedule between flying over to the UK and ghost busting and keynote speaking and talking to dead people. You got a lot on your plate.
I always do. I'm one of those creative individuals.
Thank God for that. Well, I have to ask you because, you know, I know because I've watched a lot of your videos, and for people who want to go and learn more, go to ChristopherFleming.com or Soulman Media is another way to find you. You're on Facebook, you're on Instagram, you're social media savvy, but you are bopping around a lot. So when did you, for the listener that doesn't know, when did you start to tap into your intuitive gifts on a regular basis? Because I think a lot of us as kids had these sort of inklings that something was going on, but right. We didn't really have anybody with the toolbox to help us through it.
Right.
For you, when did you embrace it and know what this was and know that it was going to be your journey?
I was about 3.5 years old. Mm-hmm. We were living in, I believe it was Salt Lake City. My dad was playing hockey. So this would have been around 71, 72. Mm-hmm. And I had a nightmare. I woke up screaming that my sister had drowned. And my mom came running into the room, and I'm crying, and I'm
And you were how old at this time?
I was about 3.5.
Okay, yeah, 3.5, okay.
I was in hysterics. Mm. And my mom has had prophecies, visions, dreams that come true. It was passed on from her mother. So she was well aware that this emotional state I was in, as dramatic as it was, there was something to it. So she went and looked at my sister, made sure my sister was okay, and she sat me down, and she says, Chris, I want you to tell me exactly what you dreamt. Mm-hmm. And I went through it from the beginning to the end. And my mom stopped me. And what ended up happening was she says, listen to me. If this ever happens, don't jump in the water, the darkness that you described. I want you to race and get help. Mm. I said, okay. 6 months later, we had moved into this apartment in Salt Lake City. And there's a bunch of family members over. And they all decided to, hey, you know, why don't you kids go outside? You're getting noisy. So we go outside. And it was in the late fall. So one of the older girls says, is there a pool around here? I said, yeah, there's a pool. So we go over to the pool, and there's a tarp on it, but it's filled in with water because it had snowed and then melted. And she says, everybody, let's play a game. Everybody touched their foot on the tarp. So we all did that. She was holding my sister's hand. My sister was about 1.5, and she had a snowsuit on. Mm-hmm. And so my sister goes to do it, and my sister slipped out of her hand, slid down the tarp right into the pool of water.
Oh, my gosh.
Now, luckily, with the snowsuit that my sister had on, she was floating. But as she was sitting there, I wasn't thinking anything of it. I'm watching. I said, well, get her, get her. And there was no immediate danger yet because we didn't think about flotation and much when you're a kid. But the girl goes and gets a skimmer.
Uh-huh.
Oh, my God, I remember that in the dream. Then she throws what I thought as a kid was a giant lifesaver, was a life preserver. She throws the old-fashioned white life preserver. As soon as she did that, we called it in psychology a trigger.
Yeah.
Trigger was like, oh, the dream. My sister's going to drown.
Oh, no.
What did my mom tell me? What did my mom condition me to race back?
Go get help.
So I started screaming through the parking lot. There was the maintenance guy working on the front of the door. He says, what's going on? I said, my sister's drowning. He raced over to the pool. My mom and the family came out. We got there just in time. They created a human chain. And just as they were trying to reach for my sister, the snowsuit had filled up and she went under.
Wow.
So my mom pulled her out 2 seconds after she submerged. Because of that dream, I reacted appropriately. My mom recognized it and taught me. So that was my introduction to ESP, extrasensory perception.
Absolutely. And if everybody had somebody to walk us through these moments, right? Who knows what kind of things? And that brings up an interesting point. So what you saw was a possible end.
Correct.
To your sister's life.
Correct.
Possible, right? A branch point, whatever it might be, right?
Right.
But because of free will and because of destiny and all these different things, you changed that trajectory.
Mm-hmm.
What is it that you believe? Do we all have several options when we can check out? Do we all? Tell me about your belief system and when we leave this plane.
I've been down an incredible road. I mean, since I was a child. I've seen ghosts, various entities from multiple dimensions. I became fascinated in the 90s, published a magazine called Unknown Magazine, dealing with the paranormal, interviewing people all over the world.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.